not my mysterious kink. I used to go about fully believing I was invisible. The legendary invisible rock singer, I would open my mouth and spew forth no blues, no news, just hey mate, yeah you over here, boo, just for a moment I would materialize. Anyway, people started to talk about this legendary, mysterious, loudmouth, invisible rock singer, cowboy. I began to cool, come back, materialize, even though I wasn't meaning to. People began to come and see this invisible loudmouth rock singer cowboy. You know, soon people would sit behind me at cafes and say he thinks he's invisible, watch. Geez, you know, I hate to keep him waiting. I tried my best, I got quite upset. Then I thought, it's not such a bad thing to be seen as a guy who thinks he can't be seen, even though I know I can. It's quite a trip. I mean, in certain circumstances, certain places, anything goes if you're known. If you got a name around town as a guy, you'll do anything if nobody's looking. But if everybody's looking, 'cause they think he thinks he can't be seen, I mean, they scared. Like they think I can't see them. It's like I'm blind, like I'm invisible. You know, soon everybody's looking, 'cause they think I think nobody's looking. So I can't not be seen, so I'm not looking at them. I know exactly where they are. And even if I was, they couldn't see me, because they're too busy waiting for me to dematerialize right there in front of them. Actually, what a place to hide. I mean, say you were a spy, an undercover man, somebody on the run. What better place to disappear? What a cover, a lead singer in a rock and roll band. You're poor, you're stoned, you're a slave to an unnameable half-forgotten ambition. You're just another guy on the lost highway, a rambling man, pirate of love, rider on the range, seventh son of a seventh son, a love rustler, a desperado, a Boston white royal, historically entitled to be bad. The man in black, John the Conqueror, the world's forgotten boy. Meet man, Mr. Blues. The foe and fog, the sober fox, the